wrestling fans. Welcome to this week's edition of Superstars of the Ring. I am your host, Eric Snook. We are just on the heels of our big event at the Columbus Social Club. It was an exciting night. Next week, we will actually show you that match between Unstoppable Eric Moore and the heavyweight champion, Daniel Anderson. It was an exciting match. I don't want to give it too much away. Just be sure to stay in tune for next week. For this week's edition, though, our match of the week is going to feature our tag team champions, K9 Carnage. That's Mad Dog Miller, Bad Dog Brody. They have been dominating the tag team scene here for months and months. A while back, they issued an open challenge, an open door policy here. Basically, that means any tag team in the area, if they want to come and challenge for the CCW tag team titles, even if they're not a part of our company, they have the option to do so. We saw that a while back with Bad Guys, Inc. They're out of Atlanta, Georgia. They challenged for that CCW Tag Team Championship. And this time, for this week's match, we actually had an accepted challenge from Vernon Black and Mayhem Julian Marks. These guys challenged K9 Carnage. It was a crazy, exciting match. A lot of hard hits. So for that, let's go ahead and get into this week's match of the week. K9 Carnage taking on Vernon Black and Julian Marks.
Hello, everybody. Welcome Superstars of the Ring, the match of the week, inside the squared circle, the challengers, the dealer Vernon Black into the ring, Mayhem Julian Marks, facing off against the CCW Tag Team Champion, K9 Carnage. That's Bad Dog Brody starting off in the ring, Mayhem. And reminding Bad Dog that he is a former world champ. I don't know that it's wise to pick a fight with that dog. Oh, he just clotheslined him. He may have broken his jaw. I can't believe he's still awake. Just about took his head off. Kept poking at him and poking at him and poking at him. Finally, Bad Dog Brody said he'd had enough. Clothesline Julian Marks. Marks almost landed in the fifth row. And again, Bad Dog Brody on the attack. Not going to let him run his mouth much this time. Takes him right down. Julian Marks looking for his tag team partner. The dealer tagged himself in. And some arrogance out of the dealer saying he's got this. Not sure what's wrong with him. And he pokes Bad Dog Brody in the eye. Black goes for the clothesline, misses, and is on the receiving end of one of the most devastating clotheslines I've ever seen. Now it's just more trouble for Vernon Black as Mad Dog Miller's tagged in. And there's a double shoulder tackle. The dealer's in a bad place. Mad Dog Miller driving that elbow to the heart of the dealer. And Bad Dog Brody, little copycat wrestling there, does the same thing, tags Mad Dog back into the ring. Big splash. They're just taking turns. They keep this cycle up just every couple of seconds, tagging the fresh man in. Mad Dog Miller just wearing Vernon Black down. Setting him up for a suplex. Letting all the blood rush to the head. The strength of Mad Dog Miller. And he finally takes him down. That could be enough to end the match. But Mad Dog Miller's not finished. Mayhem tagged in. Mad Dog didn't see it. Now he's being attacked from behind by Mayhem Julian Marks. He's going to try to get every shot he can in while the ref's got his back turned, trying to get Mad Dog Brody back out of the ring. For the first time in this match, the team of Mayhem Julian Marks and the dealer Vernon Black have an advantage. And as soon as they had an advantage, it was gone. Mad Dog Miller back on the attack. Brody's in the ring now. He's the legal man. Could be another shoulder tackle. No, a double clothesline. This could be a diving headbutt. Man that size jumping off the rope halfway across the ring, delivering a devastating diving headbutt. Julian Marks is on the outside of the ring. He's the legal man. Dealer shouting at him to get back in the ring. Finally making his way back into the ring. The ref's still counting. All the way to a 9 count. We're back underway. And the dealer tags himself in again. Looks like there might be some miscommunication between Vernon Black and Mayhem Julian Marks. Bulldog, Vernon Black down. They could probably sit on top of him and count to 100. But K9 Carnage looking to prove a point here tonight. It's cannonball-like shots to the chest and the head of the dealer Vernon Black. Absolutely academic from here. And his partner is not even on the apron anymore. Mayhem Julian Marks is arguing with one of the CCW fans ringside. And now he tries to get in to help. Julian Marks using Vernon Black as bait so he can go into the attack. Effective as it is, it's not very good teamwork to set your partner up like that to be brutalized by men the size of K9 Carnage. Julian Marks getting the big man up and over with a suplex. He mentioned it earlier in the match, he's a former world champion. And he's in control now. That was our first pin attempt of the evening. Only good enough for a 1 count. kicks him. Vernon Black kicks him right in the face. While legal, that's a bit of a cheap, dirty shot. Bad Dog Brody needs to make a tag, but he's clear across the ring from his partner. That's a very tentative tag in by Julian Marks. Goes to the second turnbuckle, jumps off, bringing all his force that he can to the abdomen of Bad Dog Brody, pummeling him in the corner. Bad Dog Brody returning with some heavy shots of his own. He needs to make a tag. And he finally gets the tag in. Mad Dog Miller, the fresher man, going to work in the corner. And he just bull rushes him. K9 Carnage wanted to prove a point here tonight, and I can't imagine anybody can doubt that they are the number one tag team in the world. And again, the dealer tagged in. Bad Dog Brody saw it. We have a 3D. That should be it. Dealer's the legal man. And that is it. K9 Carnage. They came, they saw, they conquered. They are the CCW Tag Team Champions. And they are on a roll.
Welcome back, fans. Crazy exciting match with K9 Carnage. I mentioned earlier that open challenge policy they have, and I mentioned Bad Guys Inc. These guys are out of Atlanta, Georgia. They are truly bad guys. We haven't seen anybody toss around the likes of Mad Dog Miller and Bad Dog Brody here in CCW. And we also saw a while back that they jumped K9 Carnage while they were in a workout. They are not done with K9 Carnage. They want another shot at the CCW Tag Team Championship. In fact, we were to catch up with them recently, and that's going to be our interview this week. So we're going to take it away to Bad Guys, Inc.
K9 Carnage, on March the 5th in Sparks, Georgia, you stole a victory from us. We don't know if you were in cahoots with the ref, and we really don't care. You can almost say we got a bad taste in our mouth. We're almost in a foul mood.
Foul mood? Nah, homeboy, we ain't in a foul mood. We're pissed off. See, you robbed us. We ain't cool with that. We ain't coming to wrestle. We're coming to fight. So bring your A game, because it's going down. Tell him, playboy.
You see, my old man used to tell me, when you got a disobedient dog, the best thing you can do to him is take him out behind the woodshed and put a bullet to the head.
Welcome back, wrestling fans. There we heard from Bad Guys Inc. Clearly, they are not done here in CCW. They're not done chasing after K9 Carnage and the CCW Tag Team Championship. Now, this week, we're going to get into our spotlight, our superstar spotlight. It's going to be with the 2015 Rookie of the Year, the American Prodigy. Recently, he's had a run of bad luck, taking on Less Fortunate. We saw that match last week where Less Fortunate used his cunning and his cheating skills to take the victory over American Prodigy. But now Prodigy's looking forward, and we're going to take you away to this week's Superstar Spotlight with the American Prodigy.
Yeah. upon a time there was a part of me I shared. Years before they took away the part of me that cared. I've been a thousand places and shook a million hands.
Back, wrestling fans, we are just about done with this week's edition of Superstars of the Ring. Stay tuned for coming live events here in CCW. It's going to be very exciting. We have some big shows that are going to be announced here in the next few weeks. Don't forget to check out our merchandise section at ccwrestling.biz. You can get some great t-shirts, some great masks, among other things. Next week on Superstars of the Ring, we will show you the controversial and exciting match between unstoppable Eric Moore and the CCW heavyweight champion Daniel Anderson. But for this week, I am your host Eric Snook, and we'll see you next week.